I'm trying to figure out what kind of things I should do in this crazy world. The last thing I did, the Arkham cowl, and I did that the old-fashioned way with a sculpture and everything like that. And everything has gone digital printing and right off the crystal clear video image, and the whole world's gone superhero fanatic. What I could do is just keep on doing what I'm doing. I don't really know, and this is what I started off with. I know some people like the old movies. Some movies never go out of style, right? But I'm not sure. I put a video out of this. What about that project? Everybody's just doing the costuming. Nothing's unusual anymore. What is going to happen when everything is like this and there's nothing unusual anymore? Does it just keep going and we just say this is what we're going to do? I mean, there's still a calling for this type of thing. Some of those crazy movies that came in between, some people still kind of like that because they were born into that era. And I was a little bit before that. I was more the Adam West. Actual screen used cape. Somebody painted it with improper paint. But it's still a piece of history. 25 years. That's pretty much when I started. I went in the Chinese theater in Hollywood in 1989. It was the summer. I was on my honeymoon here in California. I walked in and there on the maroon curtain was projected the bat symbol. I hadn't seen that. I didn't think I was ever gonna see it. So I go, this is the first day of the rest of my life. My life's gonna change. That was put there for me. There's a million bat fans out there. There's a million superhero fans out there. But you know how you always say, I'm the biggest fan, I'm your biggest fan, I'm your biggest fan. Well, in a lot of ways, I really am. And I think my life has ended up proving that out. Adam West passed away. Everything's changed. The world's changed. The way we're living the world's changed. I guess I finally got past the hurricanes and moved and got a cave and did a few more things and said to myself, okay, what do I do now? Reached out to the bat community that I was always really close with. They're changed. They're different. They're doing things different. Everybody's scattered all over. I can't really talk to anybody very well. It's just so fragmented. I finally have a place. I finally can work and talk with everyone. But I can't afford to make mistakes. I did a video recently about what should I do next? Should I do a new cowl? Should I do the community doesn't exist in the form that it used to exist. I can't just say what I used to say and talk the way I used to talk and be the way I used to be and do the things I used to do. I'm a creative artist. I can sit here and I can create. But what I can't do is understand the thing that's already been created, that is the crazy world out there. So what I need to work on is interpretation of that. I've got all kinds of things that I could be doing, and I can't decide what would be the best thing. Now, on a daily basis, I do the same things all the time. Everything latex. No, nobody does it. I found my little niche there too. Nobody works with just latex. I do that kind of thing on a daily basis. I don't put it on the boards and things because, well, it's the same thing all the time. But I want to do new things. I want to do other things that are exciting and fun. I started a couple of things and it's just not the same anymore because people are just off and doing all these other things, and the world that I thought I was coming back to no longer exists. So I guess I'm just doing the second video in the row of what next. I've done so much over this time period and I could do so much more, but I just can't put my finger on what to do with things fragmented as much as they are. I've got different pieces of this and that. I've been offering high quality latex pieces all these years. Well, now people are offering full suits, I think, sometimes. I've been trying to stay away from symbols and full suits and calling things what some people think they might look like. I've gotten away from all that. Everyone else is doing it blatantly. The generic route was good at first because I was the only one out there doing those things. If I'm feeling emotional ties to my past, like Super Friends or Adam West, the world's evolving too fast. There's so few people feeling those same emotional ties. I look at some of these old cowls and I say, golly gee, why couldn't we have just gone this route? You know, just those crazy Clooney and Kilmer videos, and then, oh gosh, the ones after that, The Begins was kind of good, but then the other ones got boring and long, drawn out, and now we got some other thing, and it seems like it's not competing. It's not competing like Marvel. The future seems so up in the air. I guess I'm kind of living a feeling of my finger on the pulse beat of what the actual industry is doing. I guess I'm still tied in with that. What would Batman do? He'd sit there and work and study and prepare himself and wait until a calling came. I guess I'll probably end up doing that as well. But in the meantime, I'm around. I'm doing the same things I've been doing for 25 years. And again, I put the call out there. If you want to talk with me about these things, if you have any specific needs, by all means, you know, let me know, because I'm still doing these types of things and I can help you. I can help you personally. Not so much with customization, because most people don't realize how long it takes to do customization, and most people don't have the ability to understand that and want me to do that. I'm just saying, hey, you know, maybe not customization, but maybe something done your way, you know, as opposed to just cookie cutter. What would you like? What kind of special little things can I do to make your experience in your costume what you want it to be?